Hi there, welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and in this video we're talking about inverse proportion. Now, it actually turns out inverse proportion is the opposite, or inverse, of direct proportion. So we must start with what direct proportion was about. Do you remember what it meant for two quantities to be in direct proportion with each other, or directly proportional to each other? Pause and have a think. I really need you to know this now, so double check you know this. If two quantities are in direct proportion, then we know the following is true. One quantity increases at the same rate the other quantity increases. Or one quantity decreases at the same rate the other quantity does. And let me give you an example, a nice easy example. Two builders cost £600 to hire. And I've said to you before, you could write it as a ratio, two builders, £600. Okay, now this is what I mean about them increasing at the same rate. Say I doubled my number of builders. Say I multiplied this by two here. So I had four builders. How much would four builders cost me? Well, if two builders cost me £600, four builders would cost me twice as much, wouldn't it? They'd cost me £1,200. I'd also have to double that. Now, what if I said to you, right, how much would one builder cost, however? How much would one builder cost? Well, if I know two builders cost £600, one builder would cost less, wouldn't it? I'd have to divide that by two, and similarly, I'd divide the price by two. So I would imagine that one builder would therefore only cost £300, right? And that is a typical example of quantities, your number of builders, being directly proportional to another quantity, the price to hire them. But what about this scenario? Let me show you a different one. Two builders take 600 days to complete a project. Have a think, is that the same or different? Well, we've got two builders, right? We've also got this one costs £600 and this one 600 days, so 600 is a key thing here. And also, I could write this as the ratio two builders, right, to they take 600 days. Now, this is where you've got to think really logically. What if I told you you had four builders to do a certain project? What if I told you you have double the number of builders? You don't have two, you double two and you've got four builders. What happens to your number of days to complete the project? Have a real think. Well, it's going to half, isn't it? You don't multiply by two, you half it, you divide by two. And it would take you 300 days. Because the more builders you have on site, the less time it takes you to finish the same project. And what if I told you actually you only had one builder? So you know that two builders take 600 days. So what if you had one builder? What if you halved your number of builders? You divided it by two. Well, then it would take your project longer, wouldn't it? It would double the length of your project because you've only got one builder. So it would take you 1,200 days. And the scenario on the right-hand side is a typical example of something, two quantities, your number of builders and your number of days, that are inversely proportional to each other. All right? So what is that? Well, inverse proportion. Two quantities are said to be in inverse proportion or inversely proportional if one quantity increases at the same rate the other decreases. So say one quantity doubled, right? The other quantity would half. If one quantity increased by 7, the other quantity would decrease or be divided by 7. And alternatively, if one quantity decreased or was divided by 3, the other one would increase by 3. And that's the key idea about inverse proportion. Now, just before we do some examples, I just want to go back. How are you going to know whether it's direct or inverse proportion? How are you going to know? Well, the truth is you've just got to read the question super carefully and you've got to use your common sense and logic. Here, obviously, if you increase your number of builders, you increase your cost. Here, obviously, if you increase your number of builders, you decrease your time for the project because you've got more people doing the job. So you've just got to think really clearly about which one's which. All of these ones are going to be inverse proportion. Let's do some questions. Pause the video, have a go. Okay, here, six workers will take 800 hours to finish a project. It's good to write it down as a ratio. So six workers take 800 hours to finish a project. How long will it take 12 workers? So you want how long will it take 12 workers? Now let's think about this. Is this direct or inverse proportion? If you double your number of workers, you're going to reduce your project time, so you're going to half your project time, so it's going to be 400 hours. Alright, so the answer up here would be 400 hours and you're done. Next one, pause, have a go. So this one says it takes one examiner 36 hours to mark some exam papers. So we've got 36 hours for one examiner to mark exam papers. Now it says, how long would it take four examiners to mark the exam papers? So if you had four times as many examiners, so you had four examiners, right, would it increase or decrease the amount of time you took? Well, it would obviously decrease it. So we're going to have to not multiply by four, but divide by four. And 36 divided by four is 9 hours. Therefore, the answer is, how long would it take four examiners? It would take them 9 hours, and we're done. Next one, pause the video, have a go. It says there is enough grass to feed 5 cows for 8 days. So 5 cows get fed for 8 days with this particular grass. How long would the same amount of grass feed 4 cows? Okay, let's think really carefully about this. We've got to get ourselves to 4 cows here. Right, now it's not that easy to scale straight from 5 to 4. You could multiply straight away by 4/5, but we'll do it in steps. Let's first get to 1 cow. How long would the grass feed 1 cow for? Well, we're dividing our number of cows by 5, right? So we've got less cows, so therefore the same amount of grass would feed 1 cow for much more days. So if we divide by 5, we have to increase the other one by a factor of 5, we've got to multiply by 5. So it would keep 1 cow for 40 days. Now we've got to scale up from 1 cow. From 1 cow to 4 cow, we have multiplied our number of cows by 4, right? So if we've increased our number of cows, the grass that we have is going to last for less time, isn't it? So we're going to have to divide this one by 4, and it's going to be 10 days, all right? And therefore, how long would it take? How long would the same amount of grass feed 4 cows? Well, the answer is 10 days, and we're done. Next one, pause the video, have a go. It takes 12 hours for 5 men to paint a room. So for painting a room, you've got 12 hours to 5 men. It says how many men would be needed if the room had to be painted in 10 hours. So we want to get to 10 hours. So let's first get to 1 hour, right? Let's first do that. Let's go in between and let's see 1 hour. We'll have to divide this by 12 here, right? If you wanted to do the project in 1 hour, how many men would you need? Well, you're taking your time down by a factor of 12, you're dividing by 12, so you'd have to increase your men by 12 as well. It would take 60 men 1 hour. Now, scaling up from 1 hour, if you're actually saying, well, you know what, I've got 10 times longer than 1 hour, I've got 10 hours, I multiply my hours by 10, that means I could divide my men by 10, and it would take 60 divided by 10, it would take 6 men 10 hours to complete the project. Alright, so if it takes 12 men, if it takes 12 hours for 5 men to paint a room, it would take, in 10 hours, you would need 6 men there to finish the room at the same rate. Okay, next one, pause the video, have a go. When pouring out soup, it is worked out that each person gets 3 ladles full of soup, and that will feed 120 people. So 3 ladles gives 120 people, right? The customers have complained that in the past the portions are too small, okay? And it says the cook decides to give 4 ladles full of soup to each person. How many people will that feed? Well, let's first scale down. Imagine they just gave 1 ladle to each person. 1 ladle to each person. So we've divided our number of ladles by 3. If we give less to each person, we can feed more people. We could increase our number of people that we feed by 3, and that would feed 360 people. Right? But from here, from 1 ladle, we are now multiplying by 4. We're actually saying, you know what, we'll give them 4 times as many than 1 ladle. So if you're giving more, that will feed less people, so you'll have to divide your people by 4. And you know 36 divided by 4 is 9, so 360 divided by 4 is 90 people. And there you go, the answer to this is 90 people, and we're done. And that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.